Welcome to American Odyssey Show. Dr. Effie Chow is a world-renowned Qigong Grandmaster energy healer, acupuncturist, author, international speaker, humanitarian, futurist, and visionary. In July 2000, Dr. Chow was appointed by President Clinton to the original 15-member White House Commission on Complementary and Alternative Medicine Policy. With a career that spans over 40 years, Dr. Effie Chow has been integrating alternative and traditional Chinese medicine with Western clinical practice and policy implementation. In 1973, she founded the East-West Academy of Healing Arts, EWA, in San Francisco. She is also president and founder of the American Qigong Association and World Qigong Foundation. In 1988, the Qigong Institute was established within EWA to promote research and clinical work in Qigong, a component of traditional Chinese medicine that combines movement, meditation, energetic on-site and remote healing, and regulation of breathing to enhance the flow of qi, or energy. Dr. Chow has also created the Chow Integrated Healing System, Chow Medical Qigong, CIHS, or CMQ, that is practiced by many individuals today. Clients come from all parts of the world to consult with Dr. Chow. She travels internationally to see clients, give seminars, and train practitioners to audiences up to 10,000 people in one event. She has personally made presentations to over 1 million people of all cultures and to more than 1,000 corporations, including Fortune 500 companies, hospitals, health clinics, universities, and governmental agencies. To learn more about Dr. Chow and her amazing work, please tune into this special interview by our host, Rose Hong.
First, an overall picture. I have been a director of family planning and sex education for over 15 years. And I also use the Western concept as well as the Eastern concept of what sex is in my daily work with my students and my clients. So I've integrated the concepts together. Yes, in Chinese, we talk about the male and the female, yin and yang, exist in every existence, every life form. And so therefore, if the balance is off, then there's a problem. For example, in Western medicine, there is female hormone in the male, and vice versa. And so if there is none in of one or the other in each, then the imbalance. And this is where you get abnormalities. We call it abnormality, but I don't think so. I don't want to call it that. But for example, lesbian and gays, because the hormonal and the yin and yang imbalance creates that. And it's a natural form as well. So we shouldn't look at them as oddities. It is, life is created with a balance. And so we talk about the qi in life. Qi meaning the life force, the breath. But there's another energy which is not generally talked about. It's the jing energy. And that's the sexual qi, sexual energy that the kidney is the ruler of that. Is produced by the kidney. And so therefore, that is as essential as just the qi. And if you don't have this hormone, then you become imbalanced as well.
Well, in most of the cases you see, especially in light of the sex scandals we have recently, mostly our females are being sexually abused by the victims.
Yes.
So what's the difference sexual desire and physical ability between male and female?
There is actually a physiological difference. The hormonal difference and the emotional difference is definite. And so for a female, as you know, always loved to be cajoled and made love to and petted and foreplay, and post-play too. That's really important. And so, but the male, the yang energy is sort of direct, and they can just have sex, intercourse, without pre and post approaches. And that is the greatest disharmony between the man and woman, because divorce is also very great because of the love intimacy, the misunderstanding. And the fact that people don't talk about it, then they don't talk about what pleasures them, what don't pleasures them, and what they need, and how often, all of that, you know. And so therefore, they just assume from their own thinking, they're miles apart. And so the yang energy of the world, that is how we have been created and or have evolved, is through the yang energy. The rulers were all men, and the supportive system is all female, until recently, of course. And so that, then, there's a very dire need for the yin energy to move forward. But as you know, evolution, it always goes into the extreme before it comes back into the balance. So now I believe the female suddenly realized they have a voice. And if they speak together, then they have power. So now they are coming out and is willing to admit to being harassed, being sexually, you know, violated. And but however, many of them don't, because at that time there's only a few and there were consequences. So now this is a revolution.
Well, recognizing the imbalance or differences between male and male and female, how do you balance? How do you bring harmony in daily life?
Communication, absolute communication, and understanding the differences in the yang approach and the yin approach. And we cannot just put a needle in there and hope to balance it, or put a needle in there and or else apply a pressure there, or give a medication there, or do surgery there. No way. You must deal with the psyche. You must deal with the spiritual aspect and help them understand the very different. For example, let's say from a Western standpoint, John Gray, very much, you know, the Venus, a female from Venus, a male from Mars. In one of his notes, he says the male needs sexual release every 3 days. And if you think you don't get it, then that runs into a problem. And we talk about the sexual infidelities, let's say, not even the sexual harassment, including that, is that they're not getting satisfaction where they really should be having good sex. So therefore, they look for elsewhere to satisfy their need. And it is a need, an internal need. And there are more splits in relationship and divorces from sexual incompatibilities.
Well, is that a reason or excuse for men to have higher sexual desire?
No, not
every 3 days?
No, no. It's a physical manifestation. Mm-hmm. Physical, spiritual, cellular, hormonal manifestation. And so if they don't get satisfied and that they happen to have excessive desires, then their emotions are going to create this problem that they must get it satisfied. Otherwise, their work is imbalanced. Their whole daily life is imbalanced too as well. And I need to say something interesting. Did you know that having sex helps you deal with the pain? Very few people know that if you have sex, that your pain that you're suffering from is definitely relieved. Why? The kidney energy is a very frequent basis for pain, and the sexual energy is from the kidney. And so when you have relief, and when you have sexual relationship and intercourse, it gives a total relaxation of your emotions and your physiological functions. And so therefore, you know, if you relax, your pain is better.
What about your immune system? Does sex improve your immune system as well?
Exactly. Because when you feel better and more relaxed and feeling in sync, definitely your immune system is much more powerful.
So,
and the immune system, the healthy immune system, is the basis of Chinese medicine. And if you have a good immune system, regardless, for example, in the family, some people will get TB and the others don't. Why? Because of the individual immune system.
Well, you mentioned that male has a need for every 3 days. What about women? And what is the frequency? And how often should you have sex will be considered as the optima?
Actually, with everybody, it's the individual decision as to how much they need. Woman has an emotional outlet. You know, men don't talk about these things. And well, now they do. Now the younger men are more, you know, discussant and talk about these things. But women are generally more emotionally released, volatile, maybe sometime. But they talk things away. They have friends. And men rarely have friends that they can talk about everything. But they have what some people like to say, locker room talk. That's a small group of them. But that in itself, it does release, whether it's true talk or not. You know, it's up to the individual. But definitely the ability for female to talk and chat with friends and have emotional release that way makes their sexual desire much more satisfied, let's say.
Well, let's say if the person doesn't have a partner or your partner is unable to perform as much as your needs requires. So what other ways that you can balance this, the need to create a harmony?
Remember, life is a holistic concept. So as Freud says, sublimation for what is not met. And so same with insect, so sublimation. So maybe it's a hobby that utilizes their energy and in a productive way. And others seek other sexual prowess to satisfy what they need. And if the male and female discuss the differences and have a healthy communication, then there'll be less this sexual assault that has been taking place. And also, if females understand that it's okay for them to take the lead in lovemaking, it's always the male should, although this is changing, but not fast enough. Before, it's always waiting for the man to sort of make the approach and to do the sexual, you know, acts that women feel they just wait. And sex is uninteresting because they only have one position, man on top, you know. But now, and in the Chinese theories of sex, there's a book that shows 100 different sexual positions. Some call it climbing monkey, thundering horses. Very exciting. And everybody should read it, as it's very enlightening. And so anyway, there will be a balance as we move into more communication and sex becomes not just a locker room talk or where they have prostitutes and so forth, then the whole household will be healthier. Because then you talk about sex just like, well, what are we going to have for dinner? What are we going to have for breakfast? And people tease me and laugh when I talk about sex. In my classes, I said, who's single? Who's married? Who's happy with sex? And I even asked them, how many have had 5 orgasms all in one night? And of course, that shocks them like that. But it is possible. But again, there's a lot of learning and a lot of adjustment, a lot of communication that needs to be had.
Well, I have to ask you this question. When we're talking about balance and bring harmony into a relationship, and also other ways to create that balance. So what is your view on that big letter M?
Big letter M. Oh, it's so bad. Oh, my goodness. No, it's normal. And we call it self-manipulation or self-massage instead of masturbation. Yeah, I know people just really in horror. But you know what? You massage the whole body. And so we leave that part alone. And it's like, it's taboo. Again, it goes through the attitude. No, it's quite normal to have masturbation.
It's healthy. It's very normal.
Healthy. It's very normal. If you everything is if you don't overdo, you know, if you have sex all the time, then that's bad too. And if you masturbate overly, then that's bad. But if it's enough to just relieve and make you feel comfortable, that is normal.
Dr. Chow, I have another question. Lots of people are wondering, and also not many informations are out there. In Chinese medicine, and I know there's a theory, there's a difference when you make love, having sex versus exchange of fluid. Is there any physiological differences between just having sex versus exchange of fluid?
You're talking about having sex without intercourse. Is that right? Well, we can talk about the range of sexual relationship, and everybody thinks intercourse is the only way that is known as sex. It isn't. You can have play, you can arouse the individual by various parts of the body. There's arousal points that people should learn where and how, and I won't go into the detail now. But and also for the men. The men is also as aroused, can be as aroused as the female. They have different areas, you know. And then we talk about we call about 69 position, you know. And that means oral copulation. And that is perfectly fine if the couple agrees to it. Many people say all this is, oh, how horrible, you know. And they're educated only intercourse by the one method is the only way. And so the thing is, when you have intercourse, though, the male ejaculates and the semen is absorbed by the female. And so this is one of the reasons why females and male respond differently after having had sex, is that the female absorbs the semen and gains the chi. And so she's raring to go. And in the old days, the female's supposed to be submissive. But this is why females can have multiple orgasms, and which she was restricted to before by attitude. So therefore, she gains, and this is why the man, as soon as he ejaculates, he's not in for post-play. You know, he's just, oh, I'm going to sleep.
So imbalance.
Well, he's ejaculated his life force, you know. And so he's tired, you know, from that. And the woman wants to be fondled and want to be caressed and all the post things and talk to. He doesn't have any energy to do that because he's just let his energy away. And so, therefore, if they understand that, then they would have less problem. Okay, now you talk about people sexual play and they don't have intercourse, but they still lose semen, the male still ejaculate, and it's outside, so the woman isn't absorbing it. It's not the same interaction. And he
so
still
you're
gets
not
tired.
Absorbing, you don't have the chi
That's
from
right.
the male partner.
That's right. Mm-hmm. And so therefore, it's, you know, it's dropped outside anywhere. But however, people said, I haven't had intercourse and yet I'm still pregnant. And they said, no, I can't be pregnant because I never had intercourse. And so what they didn't realize that if they ejaculate the semen around the pubic area, and even if you have panties on, the sperm very, very, you know, it travels very fast, and it can go in and also enter the vagina and into the uterus and can impregnate a
very interesting
an ovary.
Well, Dr. Chow, this is my last question. I'm sure every viewer wants to know too. What are the simple, natural ways that we can enhance our sex life?
By doing Qigong and enhancing your internal qi, making you stronger in every aspect. So I don't want people, again, to think of one aspect of the body, and that's sex. It isn't. Your sexuality is really important. Your how you carry yourself. You know, you're more appealing and more sexy, you know, when you have better posture and you are tall and your face is better. And I don't mean that looks, the beauty of just physical looks, but your presence is what attracts one person and the other. So build yourself to the healthiest you can, and your mind is positive, because if you are negative, and that's a very strong point that we teach, is a positive attitude. Even if it's negative, you can express things in a positive way and still tell us the problem. Okay?
Well,
so
what?
Living a good spiritual, emotional, and physical health to the very ultimate. An addition I'd like to make is that when I made the comment about that the male requires sex every 3 days, hormonally, you know, they are stimulated, but that doesn't mean they can't have sex every day. And in fact, people can have sex many times a day, and it isn't only in bed; it can be anywhere. And because people say, "Oh, only in bed, only when I'm prepared," it's really funny attitudes what comes along. We had a couple that said, we can only have sex if we have 2 hours to prepare for sex. I said, you'll never have sex if you wait for 2 hours before you prepare. But however, every individual's need is different. Even though I mentioned John Gray had said in his book that it was validated that hormonally men are stimulated and they feel they need sex at least 3 times, in every 3 days, but definitely every day, or it could be less. It depends on the couple. If they communicate and they're happy with once a month, okay. But if one wants it more often and the other doesn't, then there's going to be trouble.
What about women, from the medical standpoint, physical standpoint? How often do we need?
I'm not aware that there is statistics on that. But as I said, they have an outlet for their hormonal needs, any emotional need, because they communicate with other women, and they are communicative, and they let go of their problems, and they let off steam.
We have other outlets, including our menstrual period each month.
Yes.
I feel that's a release as well.
Yes. Exactly, yes. And there's also female masturbation, too, and that's quite okay. And it's funny, they need to know the physiology, the anatomy of their organs and their sexual organs, and how people should learn more about that. Then they have more tendency to abide and listen to what their body's needs are.
So the key is communication with your partners.
And communication, yes. And maybe we need education on that. Mm-hmm. And this is why in Chow Qigong, we approach these subjects very openly. And it's, as I said, it's like, what's next for dinner, you know?
Thank you, Dr. Chow. Well, if you're watching this video, if you have any questions about sex and how to have a healthy and sexy relationship, and you can send your questions or comments to us, or you can share on our social media. Well, I will see you next week and same time on same channel.
Thank you for watching today's American Odyssey with our host, Rose Hong. Please tune in to our Global Dragon TV channel on YouTube and your local cable channels. please visit our website, www.globaldragontv.com, for more exciting new programs. Are you interested in becoming the master of your own life, health, wealth, and wellness? Learn from top masters around the globe. Please visit our website at www.globalmasterclass.org.